In this video, we will see renal tubule. As we saw in previous video, nephron has two components, renal corpuscle and renal tubule. We have already covered renal corpuscle in last video, and now we will continue with renal tubule. The tubule is made up of a single layer of epithelial cells. The side of the cell facing lumen is called luminal or apical membrane, and the opposite side is called basolateral membrane. Luminal membrane has numerous microvilli. These microvilli increase the available surface area for tubular processing. Their number varies along the different parts of the tubule. Besides these small microvilli, each cell has a big central cilium which works as a mechanosensor. It detects the speed of fluid flowing in the lumen and affects the rate of transport of various solutes accordingly. Basolateral membrane is involved in extensive active transport process. Consequently, cells have abundant mitochondria located close to this membrane. They provide much needed ATP for extensive active transport. Again, the number of mitochondria in cell varies along the different parts of the tubule. The space in between two cells is called lateral interstitial space. Adjacent cells are anchored to each other by apical tight junctions. So this was the wall. Now we will see different parts of tubule. But before that, let's recall the subdivisions of medulla, as they are vital in understanding the divisions of renal tubule. This is the outer medulla. This is its outer stripe and the inner stripe. And this is the inner medulla. Now parts of the tubule. Tubule is divided into Bowman's capsule, proximal tubule, loop of Henle, distal tubule, and collecting duct. Now let's see each part one by one. We have already covered Bowman's capsule in previous video with renal corpuscle, so we will directly go to the proximal tubule. The proximal tubule is further divided into proximal convoluted tubule and proximal straight tubule. As the name suggests, proximal convoluted tubule has convolutions and proximal straight tubule is straight. Convoluted part lies entirely in the cortex, while the straight part goes deep into the outer stripe of the outer medulla. Microvilli and mitochondria are abundant in proximal tubule. Next part is loop of Henle. It has two limbs. Descending limb going up to the junction of outer and inner medulla, and ascending limb coming back towards the cortex. The loop can also be divided into a thin segment and thick segment. The cells of thin segment are thin, with very few microvilli and mitochondria. And the cells of thick segment are thick, with more microvilli and mitochondria. Descending limb is entirely thin, so it is also called thin descending limb of loop of Henle. Whereas the ascending limb has both the portions. The thin portion is called thin ascending limb, and thick portion is called thick ascending limb. Ascending limb comes out of the medulla and approaches the renal corpuscle of the same nephron. Its end lies in between afferent and efferent arteriole of the same nephron. Here it has specialized cells called macula densa. They are part of juxtaglomerular apparatus. This is loop of Henle of cortical nephron. In juxtamedullary nephron, it is slightly different. Here thin portion is longer and goes deeper in the inner medulla. This inner medullary portion plays very important role in concentrating urine. So that was the loop of Henle. Now distal tubule. It lies entirely in the cortex. Cells of the distal tubule are similar to the cells of thick ascending limb, having numerous microvilli and mitochondria. Now the collecting duct. Two or more distal tubules join to form a collecting duct. The collecting duct then descends towards the medulla. It collects urine from further nephron as it goes deeper. Furthermore, adjacent collecting ducts unite and form progressively larger collecting duct. In cortex, it is called cortical collecting duct. In outer medulla, it is called outer medullary collecting duct. And in inner medulla, it is called inner medullary collecting duct. Closer to the apex of pyramid, it is called duct of Bellini or papillary duct, which empties urine into the minor calyx. And of course, there are multiple such ducts. Epithelium of collecting duct is made up of two types of cells, principal cells and intercalated cells. Predominant type is principal cells. That's all for renal tubule. This completes the structure of nephron. In next video, we will see blood supply and nerve supply of kidney. Thank you.